have even more classes during the holidays.
Yeah.
So what's the difference between the holiday and school season? What's the difference?
Like at school, you need to spend about 9 hours a day, and about when you're outside, just maybe about 4 hours on studying, and other times you do homework and you play, and you can get up. You don't need to get up early now, and it's good. And also we can have a long we can have a trip maybe after I finish the homework.
Okay, so you'll still be having lessons, but you don't need to go to school and you'll have more fun. But the lessons won't end, they won't stop. And you told me you're going to the UK, right, for your debating club. Well, when are you going there?
Maybe so why we have winter holiday, because there it is the end of the year, so after the celebration of the year I'm going to go to the UK.
Oh, that's coming very soon. That's coming very soon. Okay, so good luck to you. So let's talk about this one. Remember the topic sentence? It should have a main subject, and you should have a controlling idea. For example, computers can appeal to different people. Then you can always change the controlling idea. For example, computers can computers can damage human health. Computers can, oh, what is this? Sorry, T. You can change the controlling idea. Computers can impact human health because of the radiation, you know? Okay, computers were invented in the 20th century. You can change, this is not a good example. So we just want to change the controlling idea. Computers are advancing in leaps and bounds. It means they're developing very fast. Okay, can you give me another controlling idea for the subject of computers?
Of computers, let me think.
Just like what I did. So I gave you two examples of a controlling idea. So can you come up with another one for the same subject?
It can
So begin with computers something.
Computers can let me see the word. I forget the words. Um, It's quite difficult because to think of a new topic.
Okay, I want you to be able to practice doing that because you have to think quickly to change topics, especially during a debate. You have to be able to do that.
Okay.
And whatever idea that you think about, it has to be true, or it has to be appropriate. Okay, I didn't prepare the topic, but I'm going to think of another controlling idea, right?
Yeah.
Computers can impact human health. Computers are advancing in leaps and bounds. Computers are becoming more and more independent. Independent, yeah. It means they can operate without human help, without human intervention. Even if people don't touch the computers can do things by themselves. Computers are starting to copy human behavior through artificial intelligence. Have you heard about that?
Yeah.
Right? Artificial intelligence is when it starts to think by itself. It starts to act like a human being. So there are so many things you can say about a computer which you develop to your topic sentence and which you can expand with more details. So I want you to make just one.
Just one, okay. So the computer people can't live without computer.
Okay, good. People can't live without computers. Is this true?
Yeah.
I don't think so. I don't think so, Jack. If your computer died tonight, do you think you will continue living? I think you'll continue being alive and having a healthy life even without your computer, right?
People will die soon without computers.
How will people die soon without computers?
The computer is connected to the man-made satellites, and with man-made satellites, we can know what is happening. Like, there's a storm coming, and we can know that. But without computers, we can't connect it to this man-made satellites, and we can't know what's happened next, and we might die soon.
Okay, your explanation is so much better than people dying soon without computers. So, although your explanation is good, your topic sentence can be a bit misleading. Okay, do you know what misleading means?
Yes, I didn't connect it to the topic.
Misleading means, okay, here, misleading. Saying something that seems true, but it really is not. Okay, that's what misleading means. Okay, do you understand what I mean?
Yeah.
Misleading. So when you say something like, people will die soon without computers, okay, although your explanation is good, the sentence is misleading. Okay, the topic sentence is misleading because this isn't strictly true. For example, 100 years ago, during the time of your great grandparents or maybe your grandparents, they didn't have computers, but they a lot of them lived a long time, right? So it's
but
not, yeah.
Because I think so the computers let people they need computers, and with a computer they can live, and maybe some people so I think of another's
stop. I want you to stay with your idea. You just need to improve your idea and improve your sentence. So your sentence should not be people will die soon without computers, but you just need to make your sentence closer to the idea that you explained to me, okay? You said without computer warning systems, people will what? People might
danger.
Might not be able to protect themselves, right? Protect themselves more efficiently. They can still survive. They can still live. Everybody can live without a computer because computers are not organic. They are man-made. They're just machines. Okay, so God made us to be able to survive on our own. So it's not true that we will die without computers. It's just not. It's not part of the natural world. So you can live a full life with or without a computer, but you told me about warning systems, computers that can warn us about catastrophes and like tsunamis or earthquakes, right? Warning systems. So then your sentence should be more specific to what you told me. Without computer warning systems, people might not be able to protect themselves.
Teacher.
From calamities.
Teacher. So I think about this topic is people will die soon without the computers, and I think about new ideas. So maybe some people might be some people they like computers so much and like to play computer games. And maybe without computer, maybe one day they will be crazy or mad. And maybe there are a crowd of people which are very interested in playing computer games. And if the computer game has been banned, so these people will be very, very angry, and maybe they will do something
they will do something drastic.
Yeah, like just what has happened in Hong Kong.
Mm-hmm. What happened in Hong Kong?
Nothing. Just the people get very mad, and they feel very angry, and they fight against the government, and maybe there's people all around the world, and maybe it will connected to the third world, and the third world begin, and maybe the many countries like such as America and Asia, they use atomic bombs, and it destroy and it caused the greenhouse gases, and also the earth like it pushed the earth into another it pushed the earth into out of this far away from the suns, and it becoming colder and colder, and Maybe may the earth may destroy because it is very cold, or maybe the Jupiter, if it missed some other planet, maybe they will just push the earth into it and the earth might explode.
Okay, the Earth will explode. I can see where you're going here.
So maybe I will change this topic into the earth.
Do you have the typing button so you can type? Do you have any typing button?
No.
Oh, you don't have it? Okay. All right, go ahead.
Maybe I will just write it down. The earth.
Do you have a stylus for your screen?
I have one, but maybe I can't count it. No, maybe I can't type it. The earth. Oh, I don't want to write. So the topic mainly is the earth might explode because
Okay, because
of the computer.
okay, Jack, look at that. Do you honestly believe the Earth will explode because of the computer?
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, because I mentioned that there are some people that they are crazy, and if they don't have computers, they will fight against the government, and it and this kind of person is all around the world, and if they fight against the government and it caused the second world and it caused the third world world, and maybe some countries will maybe they control the using of the atomic bombs and no the u nuclear weapons, and they threw a lot of nuclear weapons around the earth, and first the earth cannot afford so much atomic bombs, it might explode, and second, if just a little, it will push the earth out or far away from the sun, and maybe they will crash into another or a bigger planet, just like the Jupiter, and it will push, and the other planet will push the Earth into its planet, and if it get enough closer, it might explode because the because the atmosphere is gone because it has been taken by the other planets because of the gravity.
Okay, you mentioned a lot of interesting ideas there, which I don't necessarily disagree. I agree that that atomic bombs or nuclear weapons can destroy the Earth. If we enter into a third world war
Yep.
and countries fight against each other, we can end up damaging the Earth far more than they did in the Second World War. It's true. It's
Third
true.
world.
Yeah, we can damage it more than they did in the Second World War. So if the Third World War is going to be much worse because we have nuclear arms capability.
Yeah.
So it's true, the Earth can be destroyed further, much more than that. And it's true that due to certain technologies or some natural occurrences, the Earth can get pushed out of the orbit, right? That's what you're
Yeah.
talking about. The Earth can get pushed out of the orbit, and then we can get a bit further from. Well, if something changes in our orbit, definitely something will change in terms of time, climate,
Yeah.
weather. So all these things can affect human life. And the collision between planets, I don't know if it's possible. Maybe it's possible since meteorites travel and they collide with other heavenly bodies. It's possible that Earth can collide with another heavenly body if something happens. But still, I'm not able to find a logical connection between the computer and the Earth exploding. The computer can be one of the factors that can help make these things happen, but that is not going to be your main subject. So yeah. A closer main subject would be nuclear weapons. That would be much closer. Nuclear weapons may be the reason why, Earth will explode, right? But then your subject has changed. It's not computers anymore. It's now nuclear weapons. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? I like your ideas. You're very imaginative, but you're going further and further away from the subject. You have to learn how to stick to the subject because you need to be focused. You need to be focused on one area and expand that area according to facts, not just according to many different connections. But everything you mentioned about climate change, greenhouse gases, they are all interesting topics, but they are for a different subject. They're not for this subject. Do you understand what I mean? So I think the problem is you would like to have a very elaborate controlling idea, but it doesn't have to be. It just needs to be true. And it just needs to be connected to the subject. Okay? For example, what you said a while ago, computers. For example, I think if you say something like computers assist us in many aspects of our daily life, this is true, right? This is true, and it makes a better controlling idea because you can connect to it right away. You can see the truth of it right away. Do you know what assist means? Well, what is assist? Jack, I can't hear you anymore.
No.
Assist is to help.
Okay.
Computers helps us in many aspects of our life. It helps us order food online, do our homework, do our work, make computations. Okay? So, again, I need you to be able to connect your ideas on one subject only and not to jump so far, even though your other ideas might be very, very interesting. And also they would be true in another context. Okay, let's look at this. Let's look at page 6. I want you to check which one makes there one number has two sentences, and you have to choose which one is the better topic sentence. Okay? So I want you to read it first. Read both. Can you read letter A? I you don't have a sound. Okay.
How to read this word?
Bilingual.
Bilingual.
Yes. Yes, bilingual. Do you know what bilingual means?
Nope.
Bilingual is having two languages. So if it's a bilingual dictionary, You can have a Chinese word in it, but it's explained in English. Okay? That's a bilingual dictionary. Well, what about you, Jack? Are you a bilingual person?
Yeah, so I think yes.
What languages can you speak?
Chinese,
Yes.
English, Italian, and these three languages.
So that means you are not bilingual, you are trilingual. Have you heard of this word, trilingual?
I don't know, but I guess it's in three languages because I connected to the words.
Yes. Your sound is disappearing. I don't know why. Your microphone goes mute automatically.
Oh,
So
so I mean, it's like, and the sound is like triangle.
very good.
So I think yes, it is. So it's three.
Try
It means three
means,
language.
yes, try means three, bi means two, okay? Bilingual. So can you read the two sentences for number one?
The bilingual dictionaries can help non-native learners in two very important ways. In a bilingual dictionary, the information is
Presented.
presented into two different languages. I think.
Yes. Why did you choose letter A? Why is it the better?
Because they explain that it will help the learners in a way.
Two ways, yes. And you can expand your paragraph to talk about those two ways, right?
Yes, but the second one, so the second one, a very
Your
big
sound
topic.
disappears. I don't know why. Okay, wait. What's wrong with letter B?
So I think letter B, first, it just explained that the bilingual language, no, the bilingual dictionary, it just explain the meaning of the bilingual dictionary and also is what can it use for, but it does not explain what he is going to say. Like at a topic, I can know, oh, he's talking about it can help the learners to help them to learn language, but at letter B, I just know that he is explaining that what is the meaning of the bilingual dictionary.
Okay, yes, you're right. It's just explaining what the bilingual dictionary is, and it is a simple fact, right? It's a fact. You're saying as something true about something, you can't explain it further than the fact. Let's try number two. Read both of them.
A person who is interviewing for a job has to arrive on time to the interview. B. A person who is interviewing for a job has to do three important things during the interview. I think B is better.
Yes, B is better because you're going to expand those three important things into your paragraph. Okay?
And A only, I think A is not very good. I have two main points. The first one is that it only said one point that they have to arrive on time. But the second one is still very important because it already say what he's going to say. And maybe this article just need to explain why you need to arrive on time. And when I look at the second one, I'll see that, oh, he's going to say 3 point, but it didn't say anything about the three point. I don't know that, and maybe it will attract the reader's eyes, and the readers might be very interested in this article.
Yes, good. Because you can expand those three things, and everybody wants to know what the three important things are. They're very, they're very, when you have a number, like three important things, the 10 most amazing things, they're very attractive to the readers. You're right about that. Okay, yeah. Try number three.
Number three, there are many, I don't know how to read that word.
Theories?
Theories about who killed John F. Kennedy.
Yes. Do you know who John F. Kennedy is?
A president in America.
Right. Do you know how he died?
Somebody shot him when he's in the car.
Yeah, they assassinated him. Did they teach you that in school?
No, but I've seen a movie.
Good for you. You can learn a lot in movies. Yeah,
yes, and I think that movie is very educational.
True. A lot of movies are educational, especially the historical ones. So
Forrest Gump.
So what, which sentence?
Pardon?
Well, which sentence is the better one? Letter A or letter B?
Letter A.
Letter A, good. Because you can expand on the theories. Okay, before we go to number four, I want to ask you, what do you think theory means? What is a theory, or what are theories? Theories.
So like in this, maybe I will just explain these words in my own words, and I'll just explain the meaning in this the meaning of the words in this sentence. Mm-hmm. So I see there are many theories about who killed John F. Kennedy.
Mm-hmm.
So we actually don't know who killed him, right?
Yes.
So there are many theories. Maybe we can explain it into many kinds of point of view.
Mm-hmm. Good. There are points of view.
So he's saying that he's think that Trump killed John F. Kennedy, and maybe Obama killed John F. Kennedy, and there are many, many kinds. Because this is still a mystery, so
yes.
We don't know, and maybe someone will just want to attract your eyes, and so, oh, I know who killed him. It's blah, 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 and somebody will believe in him, and somebody don't. And maybe someone were jealous to him. Oh, he'll attract many people, and I will think of a new one. So I think who killed John F. Kennedy, and Many people believe in him. So there are many kinds. So I think maybe theories is made. It's
So very simply, a theory is what? It's just an idea, right?
Yeah.
It's an idea that you cannot prove.
Yeah.
So you're right about that. There are a lot of different ideas about who killed Kennedy. But one thing is for sure, I'm sure that Obama and Trump could not, no, they could not have killed Kennedy. Do you know why?
Because they did not born.
Yes. They were either weren't born yet, or maybe they were just very, very young during the, maybe they were just probably children when Kennedy was killed. So,
yeah.
But you know, I have an idea of who killed Kennedy, because Kennedy had a lot of enemies. He was doing certain things in America that helped America, and there were some people who wanted to take advantage of their country, and they didn't like what Kennedy was doing because Kennedy was standing in their way of achieving their goals, and Kennedy did not want to cooperate with them. I believe it was a secret society that killed him. Do you know what a secret society is?
Yes.
What is it? Secret society? What's that?
Like, what do spy do?
Like what?
Like what a spy do?
Oh, like what a spy does?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, it's something like that. It's a secret society is actually like a club of very powerful men. Most of them are businessmen. Some of them are even leaders, world leaders. So in that secret society, they plan things for the country.
Yeah.
And those people, one of those people killed him. Anyway, try number four. Choose the better topic sentence for number four.
Okay. Smartphones have a number of useful features. Smartphones use touch screen technology.
Okay, Jack, always pronounce the S. Smartphones.
Smartphones.
And say features.
Features. What's the meaning of features?
A feature is something that a smartphone can do.
Like what?
Like, for example, a smartphone can do streaming video. Okay. A smartphone can do, can handle different apps.
Yeah.
But you know, maybe before you were born, we didn't have any smartphones. We had analog phones. We had regular phones that didn't have a touchscreen, that couldn't do videos. We can't watch TV on them. So smartphones.
Yeah, and I think maybe it is very big.
Yeah, they used to be quite big, and you can only dial on them.
Look like this.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, with a big antenna, right? And there are
like a man's hands, just like this big. Yeah, and just like hello.
Yes, that's right. That is absolutely true. So I saw some of those early smartphones. They were a bit big. I had one of them, and they didn't work very well. The signal was so poor. So
and don't use them when it is raining.
Yeah, you can't use them when it's raining. Good.
You can't use them like here is the phone, and when the lightning comes.
Okay.
Because it's too long, and at that time, maybe the house is often not very tall. like when you're using the Wi-Fi, it's not very good. Like house is just like this big. You think the Wi-Fi is not very good, and you go outside and have a phone, and it's taller than your house. And when it is raining and then dogs, maybe, and it is also lightning, boom.
Exactly, true. So that's what a feature is. A feature is what it can do. So the smartphone can do so many things that our old phones cannot do. So you can't imagine how fortunate you are to have this kind of technology in your generation.
Yeah.
So which sentence is a better topic sentence then?
A.
Definitely A. Okay, what about number five?
Number five. Fossils. How to read this word?
Fossils.
Fossils. What's the meaning?
Okay, I will show you a picture of a fossil.
When I first see this word, it remind me a movie.
What kind of movie?
Star Wars. I think this word is forces.
Force, let the force be with you. Force is different from fossil.
Yeah.
Okay, you're.
It's going to have the Star Wars 9 soon.
Are you going to watch that movie?
Yeah.
Star Wars.
And its name is Sky. And the name is about the Skywalker.
Yeah, I saw it. I think it's out already. Or yeah. I'm not sure and if it's out or it's not. Good.
Because one day when I was watching TV, I saw AD, and it said new kinds of colors with Star Wars people on it, and there's one people and has a.
Are you talking about tumblers, like the cups that they're giving away?
And have a
lightsaber. So you're a Star Wars fan.
Yes, and also I'm a Harry Potter fan.
Okay.
I like these two movies very much, especially Harry Potter.
Do you know that I have my own lightsaber? Do you want me to show you my lightsaber?
Yes.
You want to see it now?
Maybe after class.
Okay, I'll show you after class. Okay, here. You know,
maybe when I'm grade five, I have a dream that I become a Skywalker, and at that time I like Star Wars so much, and my mom buy a lot of Lego about the Star Wars to me, and I want to buy a lightsaber, and there's one, and it's about it's about 1,000 RMB.
1,000 yuan?
Yeah.
One lightsaber? Maybe it's a really good one. Is it expensive?
Yes, it's very expensive. Like a one in Destiny is only need 50 yuan.
Okay.
That's so expensive.
I'm interested in seeing that. Anyway, do you see the photo? Do you see the picture on the screen?
Yes.
That's a fossil.
Oh, like so, the dragon, no, the dinosaur.
Yeah, like dinosaurs or any kind of plant or animal that died a long time ago, and then they make a print on the rock. That is a fossil.
Yeah, I always get wrong with two words. One is dragon, one is dinosaur. Because I like How to Train Your Dragon so much.
Do you believe that dragons are real?
I want a toothless.
What?
It's so cute.
Do you believe that dragons are real? Are they true?
No.
Do you know that I believe that dragons are real?
Why?
In China, you have a lot of dragon imagery, right? You have a lot of dragon symbols.
Yes, but it's actually not real. The people have the im have imagined the dragon because they think it's just like the Egypt, the golden age in Egypt, you know, and they believe in gods, like the sun gods, and they control something in the something that happens in the world. And also in China, there's many legends of this these gods, like the dragons. The dragons control the sea.
Yes.
And when it is raining, how much and where it shouldn't rains. And it will tell them into the gods of all the gods, like and he will tell him, so today here in Guangzhou, and you there today is very dry, it didn't need any clouds on it, and there's no thunders, and it is only sounds, maybe the sun gods will come here and put the sunshine. And
Okay.
yeah, so that's why the people believe in the dragons. They'll think of something that is, they'll think of something, oh,
Something to explain it.
but they didn't see it before. They'll just imagine, oh, there is something that control the sea and also control when it is raining.
But that is only our theory. We don't know if that's true or not. I think they actually saw the dragons and they really did believe in the gods. They saw the gods that they were worshiping. And in fact, I want you to research this guy. His name is Marco Polo. Do you know Marco Polo?
Yeah.
He's a very, very famous European, right? He visited
Traveler,
he was
he's a
a
traveler.
Yeah, he was a traveler, a European traveler. He visited China a long time ago. Do you know that he kept some diaries? He had some notebooks and he wrote about his travels. And he said, so Marco Polo is a historical figure. In one of his writings, he said that he actually saw a dragon. He was an eyewitness
So.
to the Chinese dragon. You know, the white and red Chinese dragons. He saw them. So you can search this on the internet.
So teacher, you means that Marco Polo. So is that means that Marco Polo traveled by himself or traveled with?
He lived in China. Well, he was surrounded by many people and he became well known in court, right?
So when he come back to Europe, nobody know. Nobody go with him, only him. And he is with a lot of Chinese people and they didn't come back into Europe. So he can see anything that attracts the European people's ears. Like, oh, I saw the dragons. There's a kind of very huge and enormous animals that can eat peoples and control the seas and when to rain. And he can imagine anything. And just attract them, think that oh he's very famous and he's very good. He saw some kinds of animals that we hadn't seen before. And if there is animal, no, if there is dragon, true in the dragons is in China. You know, the dragons can fly and can go everywhere, except it has a Harry Potter's invisibility clothes.
Okay, so
So,
you think that he's exaggerating, that he saw something else and it wasn't really a dragon? That that's what you think. Yeah, maybe that's also a possibility because we're not really sure. So,
That if the dragon is true, it's so scary.
But if
Yeah.
dragons were true, that would be really interesting, right? But I believe he saw a dragon, maybe not as big as the ones you see in the movies, but he saw a similar animal that looks exactly like the dragons that you have in Chinese history. So I don't know. I need to study that a bit more. But I did some reading some time ago, and I'm convinced that dragons are real because they're related to the reptile. The reptilian animals that we have, they're very similar. And anyway, another
So, are
topic.
you studying in animals?
Yeah, I read about anything and everything because I'm also a writer. I'm a writer and a teacher, so it's my job to read about everything and to study everything, even math or whatever it
Okay.
is. So it's an interesting topic. You could try and search it and see for yourself if it's true or not. So anyway, we don't have time left. Next time I'll show you my lightsaber.
Okay.
And let's continue with page. So we're done with this.
Yeah.
Let's continue. Prepare for page 7 next time, okay?
Yeah.
Page.
Okay.
All right. Okay, have a good night. I'll see you
Good
next
night.
time. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.
Bye-bye.